Welcome to all, and my priority is execution of foundation and footing for a commercial complex. And our team members are P. Anvesh, G. Kaushik Reddy and N. Tripathi. And coming to introduction, construction is one form or the other has been practiced since the Dana civilization. Construction in India is the second largest industry to agriculture and it provides employment to about 33 million people. The performance of construction projects in India have not been encouraging due to time and cost overruns and disputes in various contracts. Every construction has its own requirements and importance. In this commercialized world, construction plays a vital role. And coming to site excavation, this is considered as the first step during any construction, especially for laying footings based on site location. The excavation shall conform to the lines and levels as shown in the drawings and as directed by the engineer in charge. And considerations in site excavation, the contractor shall not excavate outside the limits of excavation. Any excess depth or width excavated beyond the specified levels or dimensions and the drawing shall be made good at the cost of the contractor with the concrete as specified for a foundation. It includes dressing the pits and excavated materials after dumping as directed by the engineer in charge. And classification of excavated materials. So first one is soil. It comprises of topsoil, turf, sand, clay, mud, peat, black cotton soil, shale, murram, etc. whose dimensions does not exceed 300 mm and which can be yielded by ordinary application of pick, spade or shovel or rake or any other digging equipment. And ordinary rock, how we excavated these includes particles of dimensions of having size greater than 300 mm. Laterite, shales and conglomerates, varieties of limestone and sandstone, etc. Stone masonry, brick work in cement, lime mortar below ground level, reinforced cement concrete and boulders having maximum dimensions in any direction of more than 300 mm, loose or embedded in soil, may or may not be requiring blasting or classified ordinary rocks. And this image shows the excavation part. Coming to hard rock, this shell comprises granites, basalt and similar rocks for the excavation of which the use of mechanical plant and blasting is required. Hard rock requiring blasting, but where blasting is prohibited for any reason and excavation has to be carried out by chiseling, wedging or any other agreed method. Coming to blasting operations, blasting shall be carried out in a manner that completes the excavation to the lines and levels as indicated in the drawings with the least disturbance to adjacent material. It shall be done with the written permission of the engineer. All sanitary laws, regulations, rules and etc. The magazine for storage of explosives shall be limited to the designs and specifications of the explosive department concerned and located at the approved site. This image shows how the load transfer. For example, building load is transferred to the first of all slab and then comes to column and is distributed to footing and finally distributed to the surrounding site. Classification of foundations. Foundations generally divide into number of ways such as shallow foundations, deep foundations, pad and strip and pile foundations. Shallow foundation. This type of foundation usually refers to those being rested on a stratum with adequate bearing capacity and laid less than 3 meters below the ground level. Common examples include the pad, stripper and raft foundations. The selection of the right type of shallow foundation normally depend upon the magnitude and disposition of the structural loads and the bearing capacity of the subsoil. foundation. Foundation is the element of a structure that serves to the support the loads superimposed to it through the transforming the elements. The primary foundation requirements are safe against structural failure, not impairing function of building, technical and economically feasible. The functions of the foundation. The function of a foundation is to transfer the structural loads from a building safely into ground and transfer loads. To transfer the live load and dead loads of the building to the soil over a large enough area so that neither the soil nor the building will to resist to frost. In areas where frost occurs to prevent frost from moving the building, dead loads are the weights of the building materials and the soil surrounding the foundations. Live loads include the weight of the people, furniture, snow, rain and wind. Direction of loads. The weight of the object is caused by gravity and results in vertical downward load. Wind can be in any direction as mentioned earlier. In addition, the foundation also serves some other functions such as prevent settlement, prevent possible movement of structure due to periodic sinkage and swelling of subsoil, allow building over water or water lodged to ground, resist uplifting or overturning forces due to wind, resist lateral force due to soil movement, underpin existing or unstable structure. This image shows the forces acting on the foundation. So in middle, first of all, under pure vertical downward loads only, first figure shows, and the middle figure shows the effect of wind action on the building. This is nothing but under lateral wind load, a tendency to turn under wind force. And the third one is the combined effect. That means under pure vertical downward loads and the under lateral wind loads. Execution of foundations. And coming to our project execution, we have done in the project in a sequential manner such that first one is clearing of site, foundation markings, matting for foundation, laying of footings, column reinforcement, shuttering and concreting. First one is the clearing of site. The structure is of commercial building. It consists of subcellar, cellar, ground floor and four floors above the ground level. For stability of the structure, the foundation should be excavated at a depth below the subcellar. Clearing of site is done by manpower that includes labor and machine power such as drilling machines. The excavation is provided at a depth of 5 feet 6 inches from the subcellar floor. And foundation marking. Marking of footing was done by considering the grid lines that are provided in the design drawings. These grid lines are laid by using the thread with plumb bob. Direction and facing of columns is done by considering the column faces of behind and adjacent columns as provided in the designer drawings. The markings for footings and columns were also laid simultaneously with foundations. While laying markings, proper care and precision must be maintained and all the dimensions must be considered as per provided. And this footage represents the footing marking. The footing mark is done by the site engineer and the column marking is done with the marker, red marker, as we easily seen in the image. Matting for foundation. Matting should be provided for the stability of the footing as it is encountered with different types of soils. Generally, matting is provided when soil bearing capacity is low, but for rock strata, matting is not necessary. Matting includes the PCC of different mixes and required thickness above the soil. Based on the type of construction in the matting provided is different, that means thickness and mix varies. And laying of matting. This image shows the laying of matting. Laying of footing. Generally, footings are laid from the projections that are based on dimensions of the columns. The footing dimensions are specified in the main designer drawings. For the footings, different types of reinforcement are used based upon the requirements. Generally, all the footing requires shuttering for exact shape of the footing. in step type of footings. The first layer is poured on the mat and the second layer is with the diminished dimensions are located on it and poured to the required height. And column reinforcement. The column reinforcement mainly depends upon the type of construction, the amount of load that it can bear. Generally, different types of reinforcement sizes are available in the market for different types of requirements. Mainly for the columns, larger diameter reinforcement provided so that it resists the axial loads which are transferred from the different floor levels. Coming to shuttering, shuttering decides the shape of the construction element. It provides the surroundings for the different construction elements like beams, columns, footings, etc. Generally, shuttering facilitates the additional protection for the column reinforcement. And coming to concrete, nowadays all constructions are using the new technologies for the mixing of the concrete. Based on the mix of concrete only, the good workability is achieved in the site. Man-made mixed concrete gives the bad results which were unaffordable for the construction. RMC, ready mix concrete, are the new technology of the concrete mixes in which all the mixing operations are done by the quality engineers, not by the labor. And weigh batch is the accurate measure for the material mixing.